everyone, it's Carrie with Scary Halloween. Today's video is going to show you how to put together a flying ghost without a kit. If you found this video helpful, like and subscribe for more Halloween DIY decor videos. Here are the supplies you'll need. If you're anything like me, you don't want to drop $270 on a kit for a flying ghost, so you piece together things on your own. First, I went on Facebook Marketplace and found a used children's bike and purchased it for $5. This has 8-inch wheels. My husband took the bike apart for me and I spray painted it black. I got a wiper motor on Amazon for $30. And you'll need one of these for the power source, which sometimes comes included in the power source. This is just a 12-volt power supply, which is typically used for a computer. Here's the coupler that will connect the motor to the wheel, which I'll show you how to do later in this video. The motor bolt is smaller than the wheel bolt, so the coupler will connect it. You'll need spider wire for the line with at least a 50-pound test, and then two fishing spindles for your line. Here's how to wire the wiper motor. I'm using a 12-volt wiper motor and a 12-volt power supply. It's important to have these matching. This here is going to be used to connect the power supply. You can see it's labeled which end is positive and negative. I used a car battery to figure out which wires powered my motor. For mine, black was negative, yellow was high speed, green was low speed, and red and white were park. I'm going to put the wires into the connector, black into negative and yellow into positive. I'm going to use a tiny screwdriver to attach it. Then you get to just plug it in. Next is connecting the motor to the wheel. The bolt on the motor is smaller diameter than the bolt on the wheel. So I'm using this reducing coupler that I bought on Amazon to join the two different sizes. It has tiny little screws to tighten on the bolts. I did end up needing to use JB Weld to really connect these solid. Okay. Just finished tightening the coupler, connecting the motor to the bike wheel. I should mention too that you can find this coupler in many different sizes. You can find the one that you need if you're piecing together random bike parts like I am. All right, so let's connect this. We'll power the flying ghost. Let's take a peek at my motor setup. I used this Tupperware container and spray painted it black to keep this weatherproof. This also houses the power supply. The motor is mounted to a bracket which I screwed through the Tupperware to attach to the pole. I also drilled a hole in the bottom of the Tupperware to feed the coupler through to connect to the wheel. Here's my return wheel. I ended up boring a hole partially into the wood and led the bolt up through the hole and attached it with a locking nut. I'm using a fish swivel on the line to keep it from twisting. My ghost will attach with another fish swivel.